Hello, everybody. Welcome to Zoomer Hall. And we have another magnificent performance in our Zoomer Hall concert series. I'm Bill Anderson from the new Classical FM. And today we are proud to present a new generation of world-class pianists. Now, these are young people who are inspiring thousands of Canadians with their music right across this great land of ours in remote communities where classical music isn't always available. We'll tell you that story and we'll hear some wonderful music. Let's begin with Angela Park and Anastasia Ryzikov.
Thank you.
Now, this group of very talented young Canadian pianists goes by the name Piano Six. We want to chat with four of them today who've managed to join us here in Zoomer Hall. And let's begin with Angela and Anastasia. Great, great performance of some music by Maurice Ravel. Tell us, Angela, a little bit more about it.
These were selections from the Mother Goose Suite that Ravel actually wrote for children. And they're very charming pieces inspired by fairy tales.
All the Mother Goose stories that we all know and love, but he did it in French, Ma Mère L'Oeil, right?
Yes.
Well, we all know that. Anastasia, tell us a bit about you. When did you determine that music was going to be your career and your life?
First of all, Bill, it's great to see you again, and very happy to be back at Classical 96.3. I determined that I wanted to be a pianist from the first day, believe it or not, but I loved the piano from the beginning, and I was able to concentrate for over an hour for my first lesson. That was, you know, I just wanted to move forward from the beginning.
And so you've been doing it ever since you were a small child. Did you start on a toy piano or what? Oh, we're thinking Mother Goose, after all.
Well, you know what? I did play on some little toy pianos, the ones with the colorful keys, the Crayola ones.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Now, you, as part of Piano Six, have visited many, many places, including this past year up in the Northwest Territories.
Yes.
So I assume the way it works, you fly in on a private jet, hop in the limo, and go to the concert hall. Is that
also,
right?
Also, they give you a martini afterwards.
Oh, okay.
Exactly.
Obviously, that's not how it happens.
No, it was so not glamorous. I came in like a long sweater and big boots. I knew where I was going. So I was like dressed for the cold, harsh winter.
What are some of the great memories of your tours with Piano Six?
Well, a few. One, for example, was that for the first performance that I played, the evening concert, I had some high stiletto heels and it broke and I'm standing up to bow and I can feel that one leg is much shorter than the other one. And I start to hobble off stage like a little chicken and I realize afterward that my shoe's broken. And the other story, which was very amusing, was while I was playing for one of the outreach programs for the children, we were playing a little game where you could, we had to express the emotion that you associate with a chord. And I played C major, which is the brightest key. We just finished a piece by Ravel in C major. And the kids' response to what they felt was depression and death.
Ooh. Never dull,
huh? That's
fantastic.
What are they teaching in these schools? These were like grade one students. They were tiny. Oh. I didn't even know they know these words. Depression? At the age of six?
Anastasia, thank you. Well, you're going to come back a little bit later in the show and play some more music for us. But right now, we're going to ask you to leave your piano bench and say welcome, please, to Marika Bernacki. Be joined by Angela Park, and they are going to give us a noisy piano bench. They're going to give us a piano four hands version here of some beautiful waltzes, a set of waltzes by the German Romantic era composer Johannes Brahms. Marika and Angela, take it away. from Piano 6, Angela Park and Marika Bernacki. Thank you very much. Great performance. And Marika, will you tell us a little bit more about what we just heard, those wonderful waltzes by Brahms?
Yes. So it's great to be here. It was great to play with you. This is actually one of the first things we played together when we first met almost 2 years ago. Just for fun like this, so we wanted to bring that back to you today. These are beautiful little gems, like you can see. The first five of 16 waltzes. They're very light because they're waltzes, but actually, I think as a cycle, they are a real masterpiece. And I can imagine, you know, Brahms writing these to sit to someone he liked. So very seductive also.
And there are stories about that, I can tell you.
I'm sure.
We won't get into them today, however. Can you pass the microphone over to Angela? I'd like to find out a little bit about your background. At what age and stage of your life did you decide it would be a career in music?
I think my path was a little more convoluted. I did start when I was 3. My older sister took piano, and I would always put her off the piano. And I begged my parents for piano lessons. And I think the teacher was like, no, you're too young. But I insisted. But when I went to university, my parents wanted me to do something that would make a little more money, be a little more stable. So I went into sciences for a few years. And music just kept coming back and kept enticing me, and opportunities kept coming up. And so it was not until maybe about 10 years ago that I just completely concentrated on piano.
And now you're dedicated to it.
Yeah, and now I can't imagine doing anything else.
Tell us what happens when you go to one of these remote communities. It's not just in, do a concert, and leave. There's a little more.
Yeah, we're there for a few days, and we do a mix of school concerts, master classes, as well as community concerts.
And you'll do workshops for teachers as well.
Yes, I haven't done that on the last tour, but that's part of the mandate, also to work with teachers.
So the community gets a concert, yes. The teachers get some coaching, and the students, they get some masterclass opportunities.
A little bit for everyone.
It sounds like a marvelous idea. Congratulations to both of you. Marika's going to come back later, so is Angela. Meantime, we're going to take just a short break here in Zoomer Hall. We're going to introduce you to the founder of Piano 6, Daniel Nukowski, after this. Welcome to the Zoomer Hall Concert Series presenting pianists Daniel Nukowski and Anastasia Rizikov from Piano 6. And here is some beautiful music, a piano suite by Sergei Rachmaninoff. From Piano 6, Daniel Nukovsky and Anastasia Ryzikov. Music by Rachmaninoff, a lovely piano suite. Anastasia, tell us more.
Well, it was written by the Ruski compositor Sergei Rachmaninoff, and it is one of four pieces of a two-piano suite, and this one is called Romance, and it is exactly that. It is romantic, it is dreamy, it is beautiful, just like love.
Uh-huh, and Rachmaninoff was a master of both. Anyway, let's move along. Meet the founder of Piano 6, Daniel Nukovsky. Welcome again. Tell us about the mission. It's to bring classical music to places where it's not usually available. What's the problem? Why isn't it not available?
There are so many communities in Canada today, that, as we discovered during our touring here, that are craving for classical music. And we actually, Piano 6 may have to grow into a greater pool of pianists, as we also discovered this year, as there is such a great demand. Schools are desperate to have, in these remote communities, to have someone come and perform and walk through the music, just take them by the hand backstage, show what the life of a concert pianist is like, show how the music they listen to is made of the exact same components as the music we play in the Western classical tradition.
Now, 2019 has been a very busy year. Tell us about some of the accomplishments and what lies ahead.
Yes, the intense month was in May when I was in Manhattan performing difficult program in Carnegie Hall with Karl Rathaus, Handel, and the 24 Preludes of Chopin. And literally the day after, I took a flight to Fort St. John, B.C., and continued the Piano 6 tour, which was quite something. Immediately at the car rental place, when I had a standard size car, which one would normally get, they said, no, you're not gonna take that. Where are you going? I said, up north, I'm gonna hit the Yukon territory. So they said, no, you're gonna take that truck. Uh-huh. And I don't know if it was a cute case of highway hypnosis, but it seemed like every single vehicle on my 4-hour ride up from Fort St. John to Fort Nelson was a Ford F-Series truck. Uh-huh. So.
It's a great country, though, isn't it?
You just see so many things. It's an absolutely beautiful country, and yeah. I had prepared a warm clothing. It was actually quite cool in the beginning of May in New York, and I eventually realized that it was warmer up in northern BC. The weather had just turned warm, which means all the black bears from the Yukon had gone south, mm-hmm. and they were grazing.
And they were hungry.
Absolutely. They were so
You've
cute.
Got some concerts in October in Brantford, a couple in Toronto, an Atlantic tour. Tell us more about what's coming up.
Yes, these are kind of one-time miracles when we can get the six pianists together in one place. It will actually happen for the first time. We've been waiting 2 years now. Tomorrow at lunch, we have all six pianists. We lost Ian Parker because he is now up in Prince Albert, Saskatchewan, doing a school concert as we speak. And David Jalbert came last week from New Brunswick, and he's catching up with his students at University of Ottawa. So we have all six of us will perform in Brantford on Sunday. And then once again, very much everyone is invited, Jane Mallet Theatre, 8 p.m. on Tuesday.
To do this wonderful work, you need sponsors, you need donors. How do people find out more all about you?
Everything is on the website, piano6.com. It's an enormous country, second largest in the world, and it requires only thanks. It is only thanks to the support of our sponsors, the Canada Council, Ontario Arts Council, Toldo Foundation, numerous private donors, that we can get us to these locations and make this happen, make the music experiences real.
We're going to have some more music soon. We're live in Zoomer Hall with the members of the Piano 6 group. And after this short break, Marika Bernacki will join Daniel, and we'll hear some music from West Side Story. Here we are in Zoomer Hall with Piano 6, and next we welcome Marika Bernacki and Daniel Nukovsky to play some magnificent music by Leonard Bernstein, Symphonic Dances from West Side Story. Thank you. Wonderful symphonic dances from West Side Story. And we are pleased to have with us today members of Piano 6, Daniel Nukowski and Marika Bernacki, playing that Leonard Bernstein music. Marika, I want you to please describe to our audience just how you followed a path to become a professional musician.
Well, like a lot of musicians, I started very young, at 5 years old. Maybe some start earlier, but 5 years old, and my father used to be a violinist, so there was music in my home, and I just started piano and taking it seriously. I grew up in Montreal, and I moved to New York, did prep school at Juilliard, stayed in New York, did my music education there, and just trying to make a career, and I enjoy a varied career as an artist, playing solo recitals. I also play with my fiance, who is an incredible American cellist, Julian Schwartz. We're in a duo, and I have a piano trio, and I teach, and I do important work with Piano 6, so all kinds of different things, and I think that's today's kind of career for musicians.
And in your spare time, you practice, right?
Oh, yeah. I love practicing, actually, so yeah, in my spare time, I practice.
And you have to, don't you? I mean, I don't think people realize just how much you have to do.
Yeah, well, we have to do everything, basically, but it's great because we love it and we believe in it.
Tell us about your greatest memory of the time you've spent with Piano 6 and some of the visits you've made.
So far, I have not gone on a tour, but it's coming up. So far, my favorite experience has been getting to know my colleagues because we didn't really know each other before. So getting to know their personalities, getting to know them musically, playing with them, and doing our gala concerts like we're doing in Brantford and in Toronto to get awareness that the group is back on its feet and that we are starting to do this important mission again.
Well, you've been attracted to the mission of Piano 6, obviously. Well, how would you define and describe the value of what it is you're doing?
Well, I think that it's our duty as musicians to do this. And as Canadian artists, it's our duty to bring this back, to go around and to stimulate and to reinvigorate communities with music. And I know that, I'm sure my colleagues, you know, have been talking about it. They love doing it. And I think it can be life-changing to the people that are there present to hear music, to talk about music, to discuss music, and to experience this with us firsthand can be life-changing for us and for them.
Well, have some great time on the road. Thank you for being with us here today.
Thank you, it's my pleasure.
In Zoomer Hall. I'm Bill Anderson. We are so pleased to have four of the six members of Piano 6 in our Zoomer Hall concert hall today. And we're going to continue with some more of their beautiful music. This time around, Daniel Nukowski has gone to another piano, but it has the same 88 keys. He's going to be joined this time by Anastasia Ryzikov. And they're going to play us some beautiful music from Scaramouche, by the French composer Darius Milhaud.
Thank you.
Live in Zoomer Hall, the members of Piano 6, will you all come out here in front of the pianos, please? Anastasia, Angela, Daniel, and Marika, come back. Let's give them a warm thanks for their wonderful performance here today. Take a bow. Now, Piano 6, of course, needs your support to continue the great mission that they are on. And you can find out more when you go to the website, www.piano6.com. Our program today has just been wonderful. Thanks again to our musicians. Thanks to all of you who joined us today in the studio audience. I'm Bill Anderson, looking forward to seeing you next time in Zoomer Hall.